What's up, guys? Back with another Twinmotion tutorial. I'm going to show you how to create a 2D floor plan using my office workspace scene. All right, let's get right into the video. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is we need to cut a section. So we're going to cut a section at the top of the model. Okay, so first thing we need to do, let's go to our library. We're going to go to our tools. We're going to go to section. And then, as you can see, we have our section cube, and we're just going to drag it out into our workspace. Okay, so now that we have our section cube out, we're going to drag it up. Just go above the roof of our scene, and we're going to drag it across on top. Okay, so I like to kind of center it as much as possible. All right, so now that we have that, I'm going to go to my scale, and we're going to enlarge our section cut. So we can just click on one of these green arrows here and just drag it out. And then we're gonna drag the other side. We're gonna drag this side. Okay, so now we have our section box that is completely over our model. And now that we have that, we can go back to our regular tool to move it. And we're just gonna go down. And as you can see, it's starting to cut our model. So now we can see everything that's going on in the inside of our model. All right, guys, if you're liking this video, smash that like button for me. We're gonna actually also do the path tracer settings, so stick around. All right, so now that we have that, let's go, you can click off of it. And we're gonna go to our icon up here. And we just wanna switch the position of our view. So we go to views, and we wanna look on top. So now you can see, we can see what's going on top. All right, so now that we have that, we're going to change the base. So right now, you can see our base is, we have a greenery grass showing. We're going to go to our library, and then go to materials. And first off, let me do something. Let me actually delete this. I don't need it. So now we're gonna go to wall coverings, and I just want the background to be completely white. So we're gonna go to matte paint wall. We're just gonna drag that over. So now we have a white background, essentially. Okay. So now that we have that, we're gonna start playing around with some of the settings so we can actually read our floor plan. So first off, let's go ahead and create our image. We're gonna go to the plus sign. We're gonna say add image. So now that we have that, we can go to the three dots up here and we can rename it. And we're gonna name it office floor plan. All right, now we got that. All right, I'm gonna zoom in here. And we're gonna start playing around with our settings now. So let's change our time of day I look at inverting. Our sun intensity is at 100,000, which is the standard setting. I'm gonna bring that all the way down. We're gonna keep these the same. So we're gonna change our location. Let's change it to right now the month is set to July. We're gonna change it to June because that's the current month that we are in. So here in the HDRI environment, we're gonna enable that. Then we're gonna go to, we're gonna keep it on sky dome. We're not gonna do a backdrop. We're gonna change the intensity to 2 and the rotation to 60 degrees. So right now we, in our HDRI preview, we have new clear 01. I wanna change that. So we click on the 3 dots, go to library. And there's a certain one that I used earlier. Let's see if we can find it. I think it was called Noon Overcast. Here we go. So Noon Overcast 01. So we're just going to drag and drop. So as you can see, it made its adjustment. Let me check the other details. Okay. So now let's go to camera and let's change some of our settings in our camera. And we're going to keep auto exposure checked. And we're gonna keep the exposure at 1. So I wanna change the white balance. Currently it's at 6,500. We're gonna change that to 4,700. Looking for a more cooler color, not so much warm. So now we're gonna scroll down. Getting at 40, we're gonna change that to 65%. I want to change my sharpness as well. I want to check something out real quick. Use your align camera. Okay, I don't want to use the align camera. Just wanted to test something out there. I don't think that's gonna work. Let's go to film back. We're gonna enable that. Well, first, before you enable your film back, so let's take a shortcut and go to image. I want this to be, so when you select film back, it's going to select whatever camera setting that you have. It's gonna take that on. So let's go back to camera, enable. We're gonna do Super 8. Okay. So now we want to refresh just to kind of keep our view updated. All right. Let's go to FX and let's play around with some of the contrast and saturation. So in the contrast here, I'm going to bring it down 45% and saturation, I'm gonna boost it up to 65%. And we're gonna add a color gradient and a filter to this. So go to color gradient and we're gonna go to day midday. Guys, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. That's fun. Okay, kind of brighten up the scene a little bit. So to filter, we're gonna go to limelight. All right. So now that we have a lot of our settings in place, let's see if it works. So let's go to render. We're gonna use the path tracer. So we're gonna select path tracer. And we're gonna pick up the samples per pixel to about, let's say 2048. And we're gonna change the max bounces to about 15. And the fireflies, we're gonna keep it at 30. Okay, so as you can see, you're starting to see the shadows, you're starting to see the floor plan a lot clearer. And this will look very well and look very good if you're trying to turn your 3D models into a 2D floor plan for a presentation. And this is how I go about doing it. And you can always play around with the settings to kind of see whatever mood or tone that you want to set for your renderings and how you want it to read. But yeah, so guys, don't forget to hit the like button, and we'll be back with another one.